Okay, hello everybody. This is my deck tech to my Abzan Deathblade deck from the Yesukai Stoneblade versus Abzan Deathblade deck gameplay. Alright, let's start with a creature base. First of all, I want to mention Vithard Shaman. He's one of my best one drops. And I play four off. He's basically the most important card for my deck because I got the early mana ramp, and he's basically never a dead draw in the late game because I always can tap him for to gain two life or to hit my opponent or to let my opponent lose two life. He's good against basically every deck. He gets much of hate, or he gets much hate, but still a must-have for my deck. Next up, Dark Confident. He lost a lot of popularity in Legacy, but I still think that he's one of the best card advantage cards. So I play four of him. He's the best 2-drop next to my Tomograph, which I will come later to. Because of my low, mostly low mana curve, I don't lose too much life to him. And with a 2-1 body, he can still hit my opponent. Next up, Stoneforge Mystic. I'm playing three of him because I only play two equipments, and I don't really rely on him too much because he's not my main win con like in other decks, and yeah, I don't want to draw him in late game plays, in the late game. Yeah, but still, he's a great card, and yeah. Now my equipment package. I play one Betterskull and one Umezawa's Jit. Jit, of course, good against many decks, against Delver-based decks and tribal decks, very good against elves. So this is a must-have in my main deck. Betterskull, one of my win cons, and also sometimes an equipped Dark Confident gets the job done. Now to my creatures. First of all, of course, Tomograph. He's my main win con. And yeah, what to say about Tomograph? He's, of course, mostly I drop him when he's out of lightning bolt range. But of course, he gets a lot of hate with Swords to Plowshares against the most decks. But still a great card. And I play three of him because I play one Tarzigur, the Golden Fang. Yeah, I'm a pretty big fan of him because most of the times he's a 4-5 for one. I don't use his ability too much because four open mana sometimes, most of the time I don't really have four open mana to play him. But if I can get some value out of it, why not? Alright, now to my disruption spells. First up, Thoughtseize. Of course, the best one mana disruption spell. Good against control decks and yeah, most blue decks in general. And yeah, to keep the early plays of my opponent in check. Yeah, I play four of them. Next up, Hinto Torek. I play three of them. A good follow up for him for Thoughtseize in turn two, but sometimes I end up sometimes it ends up just as a dead card or a discard outlet to Liliana of the Veil. But still, it's a great discard spell against most of the decks. But I mostly end up sideboarding it out, even if I'm on the play. So I might consider cutting it. Next up, Liliana of the Veil, another great disruption card against almost any deck, because it's also a great sec outlet or some kind of removal spell. It works very well with my Lingering Souls, which I committed to, and yeah, I play a 3 of her, because sometimes I don't want to have her on my starting hand and get to her later on when I have the board in check, or or I need to clean up one creature. All right, now to my spells. First up, Swords to Plowshares. A pretty cheap removal spell to keep the enemy board in check. Yeah, I play 3 of them, because with Liliana and next up Abrupt Decay, I got mostly enough removal spells. Yeah, pretty good against any creature-based decks. And yeah. Now Abrupt Decay. One of the best removal spells in the Legacy, of course, because it can't be countered. Yeah, I play four of them. Yeah, it's good against almost any decks. Yeah. Yeah. It's pretty good against almost any deck, so I play four of them. Next up, Lingering Souls. Yeah, it's a very good card. It's basically two cards in one. And it's pretty good against enemy planeswalkers. For example, Jace the Mind Sculptor or Liliana of the Veil. Sometimes they have to waste their minus ability, and you still can keep one in spirit. It's pretty good, and it's of course nice with the equipment I got in my deck. Yeah. And the last spell in my deck is Sylvan Library. Basically, it's the fifth Bob in my deck. Another great Khan Advantage card, and with Dark Confident and Sylvan Library on the battlefield, I can put the cards on my top that I don't lose that much life. Yep, that's my main 60. Now to the sideboard. I just go through the cards. I don't really set them up. Elspeth Knight Errant, pretty good guard against control decks. And still. Na, vielleicht muss ich das gleich nochmal machen. Pretty good card against control decks, and yeah, it's in my opinion, it's the best Elspeth. Sort of very nice. Mostly I end up boarding this card in every second game, because it's most of the time it's a faster clock than Better Skull, and equipped to my Lingering Souls, for example, it's often the extra card draw and the extra 2 damage. Enlightened Tutor, I got 2 Engineered Plagues. Eigentlich müsste ich nur die ganze Zeit darauf gucken, ne?
Aber mach einfach weiter.
Ja.
Schneid ab gleich
raus. Ja, vielleicht müsstest du es auch komplett nochmal machen.
Nö.
Is this my tutor for Engineered Plague? And my Needles and my Everswarm Canonist. He's in basically against Storm. Or sometimes I brought it in against elves. Yeah, Needles, I never leave the house without two needles in my sideboard. It's just a good all-round card. Again, Sensei is Divining Top, and another control deck, other control decks. Yeah, Crossing Grip. Also against, for example, an enemy Better Skull, because I don't have a main deck answer for it. Two Extipates. Another hate card for Storm, for example, with Passing Flames. Two Duress. Also against Control and Storm decks, because my main deck is pretty weak against Storm and Control decks. And two Tormod Crypt for some more Graveyard Hate. So that's it.